Pence CNN projects Donald Trump will carry the state of Montana and its three electoral votes. Another important win for Donald Trump in Montana.
In the midst of the American elections, when the public and the media are consumed by the extraordinary events in the states, a raft of reports is released by Corrections. All that volume over fight clubs at Serco. And when the less than flattering truth comes out, it barely rates a mention. There's too much else going on. But there's something useful to come out of the release of these reports, which is that under his contract, dumped former Mount Eden Prison director Gareth Sands can now talk about them because they're public. There's one in particular we want to know more about. Is this the report that you were given in May 2015?
I believe there is more in the report that's been released to the public than there is in the report
there's
that I got.
There's more in this than the one you got?
Yes.
That seems odd.
It does seem odd.
There's a lot that's odd about this investigation report, and its handling raises more questions than answers. It was produced a year before the Fight Club scandal erupted. It names gangs, specific prisoners even, involved in fight clubs, not just at Mount Eden either, at Nafa and Rimutaka too. And yet, it was sat on. Gareth Sands knew of the investigation and was asking for the report from June 2014.
You're repeatedly asking for information about a really troubling allegation, organised fight clubs at your prison. You're asking people at the very highest levels and you're asking over and over. What response did you get?
Reduce the noise of your requests.
Reduce the noise of your requests. What does that mean?
Well, I'll let you work out yourself what you think that means.
What do you think it means?
Well,
how did you take it at the time?
Well, if I'm honest, I ignored it.
So eventually his request is met, and nearly a year after he started asking for it, Gareth Sands gets the report of the investigation into organised fighting at his prison. But if there was something curious about the delay, there was also something questionable about how he was delivered the report and what he was told he could or couldn't do with it.
How were you given this report? How did you receive it?
I received it in a brown envelope with an instruction in writing and verbally to not share any wider.
You received an official department report in a brown paper envelope.
Yes. Which may be okay to pass it in a brown envelope. It may, and that's not supposed to sound sinister. The bit that I'm concerned of is the instruction of not to share any wider.
So in this digital age, a strange way to deliver the report, along with a puzzling instruction. There's only so much Sands can say, though, about this and his many other concerns. Clearly, he wants it taken further.
Paula, you will form your own views as to whether this requires a public inquiry or a royal commission. You will form your own views on that, but I'm hinting here, you've got 20% of the story, there is more to tell.
It seems that way. There are allegations of serious organised prisoner violence. They're under investigation. The prison director is asking questions at a senior level, and the response is not to give him the information he's asking for, but to tell him to reduce the noise. And in the meantime, what's he doing about his violent prison? What was Corrections doing to help?
Was I sitting around waiting for that report? No, I was not. And I think that's a key part.
What were you doing?
Well, I was increasing the staffing levels from the 277 that the prison started with in 2011. I increased it by 53 to 330.
The chief executive says that one of the roots of the problems was staffing levels. What do you say to that?
Well, I would say that the one time he visited the prison, we had a conversation about staffing levels and about working in partnership to bridge the gap. I never saw him again in the prison, and we didn't bridge the gap.
We've spoken before about tipping point. How much pushback did you give over the muster when you were concerned about the number of prisoners that you were housing. You were responsible for their safety. Did you ever give any pushback about your concerns over the muster?
Yes, I did. On the 11th of June, 2015, I specifically said I am concerned about the safety, security, and welfare of staff and prisoners. I said that to the Department of Corrections and to Serco.
He says despite his concerns, he was instructed to take more prisoners.
And you said what?
Is that your answer? Is that your response to me raising risk where I am gravely concerned? Is that your answer? To instruct me to take prisoners, even though I am telling you that it is too risky to do so? And the response was, yes, that is my answer. We've just had a murder at Christchurch. We've had attempted escapes. We've had escapes, not in my prison, elsewhere. There's been escapes, attempted escapes, murders, attempted murders, serious assaults. And I'm sitting in the prison that I'm responsible for saying, we need to be really careful here because we're going to get to a point where something happens. And it did.
It sure did. The furore that followed the Fight Club revelations was understandable, but one consequence was that it focused attention squarely on Serco-run Mount Eden. So how's that prison doing now, since Corrections took it back over? Corrections Minister Judith Collins says she has a lot of confidence in the Department of Corrections.
I want to put to you that Fight Clubs are still happening.
Well, if they are, then I expect those to be dealt with. So if they are, I'd suggest any evidence be handed over to me or to the Chief Executive of Corrections. And if they are continuing to be run, and we're always going to find this in prisons where we have particularly gang members, that they will try to do this. That Serco doesn't mean to say we're going to sit by and let that happen.
Well, apparently you are. I've just been speaking today with an inmate who's just been released from prison. He spent time at Nafa, Mount Eden and Pāri Morimo. He says the Fight Clubs are still happening right now at Mount Eden, behind closed doors and not being videoed anymore. So you might not get that evidence that you're asking for.
Well, the fact is that without, just by making allegations, that is very difficult to investigate. If you were to give me details, you can do it off camera, I'm very happy to take them. I'll provide those to the Chief Executive, and I'm sure you'll find that those matters will be dealt with very swiftly.
Next episode, what else is happening in corrections-run prisons that we should know about and be deeply concerned over?